Hi everyone, hope you're all doing well. Today we're going to talk about three things that training 212 could improve. Now, the reason why I'm doing this video is because sometimes, me included, training 212 ends up being a bit of an echo chamber. And everyone goes around saying, oh, training 212 is amazing, which it is. In my opinion, it's still the best investing platform out there in the UK. And I think most of you guys are using it. If you're not using it, I don't know why you're not using it, because it's amazing. And if you do want to join, link's in the description. You join for that link, you can get a free share worth up to £100. But today I wanted to break the echo chamber a little bit, because we're always being positive on YouTube about Trading 212. I wanted to say actually what they could do to improve things, because I know sometimes the guys from Trading 212 do watch these videos, and if you have any suggestions, make sure you put them down in the comment section below and they might see your suggestions as well. But for me, these are three things that I'd like them to make Trading 212 a little bit better. Now, saying that, Trading 212 are always looking to improve the platform. That's why it's so good. They add a lot of features in that not many other investing platforms do, and not many other features that we even think about. You know, we've had the debit card, for example, that has been added in recently, which has been amazing. The high interest rate on our cash on the in the accounts has been absolutely amazing. And they're probably going to be thinking of ideas right now that are a lot better than the ones that I'm thinking of right now. But I have three things that I would really like to see them add in to improve the platform. And if you guys have any, you know, throw them down in the comment section. But I'd really like them to do these things. And if they do, I think it'll make the platform even better. And I thought I'd post them on YouTube for you guys to watch. So first one, I'm not going to put a SIP on here. A few people might be thinking of a SIP option. I think that is going to be coming onto the platform at the end of the year. So I'm not going to put this on that, well, that one on today's video. But number one, the first thing is the homepage. I believe the Trading 212 homepage has been the same for like the last 4 or 5 years, and I think it needs a bit of an upgrade. So when you log on your account, you'll have your chart with how much you're up on the day and how much money you got in your account. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. I'm probably showing you an image right now that's not my account. It's off Google Images, but I just wanted to show you what I'm on about. So when you go on and you see that homepage, you have all your account, what you're up, and the money that you have in your portfolio, which is good for a few years ago. Now, I think that needs an upgrade because it hasn't been touched for like 4 or 5 years. And another thing that really bugs me is that it's not really a good reputation of your investing journey, because all it has is what you're up on the stocks or down on the stocks that's active. For me, a bigger thing would be like a lifetime. What are you up on the lifetime of your investing journey? Because for example, I had a stock that did really well for me, which was a larger position, which was Darktrace. I sold the position out, and yeah, you know, the most important part is that I made money on it, but the next kind of couple of weeks as I went on Trading 212, my account looked like it sank massively, even though I just locked in a massive amount of profit into my account. So rather than having what you're up and down on your active positions, I think there should be more variety on the charts that you load up. So you can have the one that's in the place at the moment, but it'd be good to have like a all time of like profit you've taken, or a chart that includes your dividends if you're a dividend investor, and also a comparison, because there's some days you go on and your account's down and you're like, well, that's a bit of a bad day. But if you could see the whole market was down, you'd maybe feel a bit better about, yeah, it's a tough day out in the market. So if you actually like had a comparison to like what the S&P is doing, and you can see how you're doing against the S&P 500, because for most of us, I mean, some of you guys watching this video might just be index investors, but some of us are like stock pickers. And if you had the option to like add a S&P, you know, 500 and how you're doing to the S&P 500, that'd be absolutely amazing. And as well as that, if you were able to track your like year-to-date performance, that'd be a lot better as well. You'd be able to work out how much you're up and down against the whole stock market. And that'd be a good new feature. So I think the homepage needs an upgrade, and it needs an upgrade where there's more features of like, not just your active positions, your all time, what you're up, as well as like comparisons against like the S&P 500, comparisons against the FTSE 100. I just think it's very basic and not a good reflection of what you've done in the stock market. So that's something that I'd really like to see upgraded on the platform. And that's probably my number one thing that I'd like to see them upgrade and give you a little bit more data and a bit more fairer comparisons, I think, overall. My second one, I would really like them to add a tab on the bottom. So on the bottom, you've got the homepage, the portfolio, your like settings. That long tab at the bottom, I would really like them to add another tab on the bottom, which was like a dividend tab. Now, this wouldn't be for everyone, but I think a lot of people would like to see it. And on that dividend tab, what you'd be able to get is your upcoming dividends, because there's other platforms that will tell you when you're going to get a dividend, how much you're getting, and when it's going to get paid. Trading 212 don't do that until you actually get paid the dividends. It'd be really good to know what days you're getting paid your dividends, how much you're getting paid your dividends, So you can track it and you can expect that to come into your, you know, into your account. But also it'd be good to see a graph. Now you can do this through external platforms, but it'd be good to have it on Trading Tools too, because they would have all the information. And have like a graph of how much you're collecting in dividends every month. And you could look at, you know, for example, you might go September 2024, this month I earned £100 in dividends. And if you look back a year ago, you could maybe look on your graph, your chart that's going up, and you'll see like, oh, a year ago, I actually only earned £50 this month in dividends. So I'm earning more in dividends, and maybe you can see your dividend wealth building up as well. And that'd be a great advantage if you're a dividend investor, and not only just a dividend investor, anyone that does have some sort of, you know, form of dividends, to see your dividend income coming up more and more every month. And as well as that, having a dividend tracker so you know when the dividend payments are coming in and when to expect them and which dividends you qualified for. I think that'd be a really, really good addition for Trading 22 to add in. The third one, I think a lot of you guys would probably put this one in the comment section if I didn't mention it, but it's the buy and selling of smaller caps. Now, this is a thing that it's not just Trading 22's fault, because when you're buying small caps, there is that liquidity issue, and you've got to accept it sometimes. Sometimes orders can be a little bit slow to go in. Sometimes, you know, if you're buying or selling, it can take a while. Sometimes it can be, the spread on the price can be a little bit big. Now you could argue the case that maybe you should be using limit orders a little bit more, but in my opinion, sometimes it would be good if Trading 22 can provide any sort of information about potentially any time they expect orders to go through, the amounts, how long, you know, a certain amount, how long they think it could go through. They could potentially tell you a variety of options or what price they could potentially expect you for the order to go through at. Any sort of more detail that they would be able to provide on that point would be very useful, because the amount of times that sometimes you put an order in and it can take like a day or two for sometimes of the orders to execute, or potentially when you put in an order in for it to execute, but also when you put an order in and sometimes, you know, you buy your position and then you're already down like 4 or 5% on your position, you know, sometimes a little bit of more awareness about what that potentially could be would be really great. Now, like I said, it's not a major Trading 22 issue, because a lot of that also goes down to liquidity, and that's part of the thing of buying small caps. But if there was any more awareness they could put around it, I think that'd be a really good addition for us users as well. But like I said, that one's a little bit out of their hands a little bit more. So I'm not gonna be too critical of that one, and that's something I can deal with. But for me, the first two, I think the homepage would be a really good update. And in my opinion, like I said, a dividend tracker built into Trading 22 would, once again, I'm surprised they've still not really done that one at all at the moment, but we'll see. Anyway, I just thought I'd talk about, break the echo chamber a little bit on YouTube, and I'll actually give a few suggestions out here and leave a space for you guys to also post your suggestions. We'll see if they do follow through them. I'm sure there's other of, you know, even bigger features that they're working on in the background, because that's what historically Trading 212 do. But I thought that would be a good video, and if, like I said, throw any in the comment section that you guys feel that they could update you with. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Hit the like button. I'll see you in a bit.